Hello everyone, my name is Rosie and I'm a discipleship pastor here at Hope Point Church. First of all, I just would like to say to our church family that I truly miss each one of you. Although we may be physically distant, but you continue to be in my heart and in my prayers, and I can't wait for the day when all of this will be settled and done and we'll be able to meet again and say like David said in Psalm 122:1. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. However, until then, I'm grateful that we can have this form of technology and we can have these devos at home and to minister to you, to encourage you, and to be connected somehow, right? So we're going through this journey together through Psalm 91. And every day of this week, one of our pastors will be, and leaders will be sharing with you a portion of the psalm. And today, I'll be sharing with you verses 9 and 10. If you make the Lord your refuge, if you make the Most High your shelter, no evil will conquer you, no plague will come near your home. So, one of the things that I see in the psalm is that you know, its author, probably Moses, is not trying to hide or minimize, right, the realities of life. He's laying out real concerns here, right? Like deadly diseases, terrors of the night, attacks, distress, evil in general. And he's making a very detailed list of the circumstances that can strike us at any time in our life. However, when in this verse, when he says, no evil will conquer you if you abide, if you dwell, if you make the Most High your shelter, your refuge, you know, no evil will conquer you. Although we're facing real concerns, the problem here is that is if you allow these concerns that we should be doing our part as well, and they are real concerns. However, we should, you know, really not allow them to become forms of anxiety and fear and, you know, distress, because otherwise this form of evil will conquer you. But once you have this, you know, these real concerns, and you can take them at the throne of our Father God, and really to lay it all down before Him, and knowing that He's protecting you, knowing that He's with you at all times, so then we can find that kind of rest, right? We can find that peace that surpasses all understanding. However, the other thing here is that the psalmist establishes, you know, at the very beginning of this psalm, he establishes our premises or our foundation, our solid ground, when he says, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High, in the shadow of the Almighty. What he's saying here when he says that, you know, the Most High, it means that there is no one above Him. There is no one above our God. And when he says, you know, who dwells in the shadow of the Almighty, it means that there is nothing more powerful than our God. So on those, you know, two statements alone, we can rest knowing who is our God. So remember when, you know, even during the storm, just remember that Jesus is there for you. Remember that our God is a good God, that He loves you. Just go to the message of the gospel, to the heart, you know, of the gospel, which is John 3:16. For God so loved the world, so loved the world, that He gave His only and begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So ask the Holy Spirit. You know, remember that you have the Holy Spirit of God in you. So ask the Holy Spirit to remind you of these truths, to reinforce you of these truths, and to comfort you, to really to bring you that peace, you know, knowing that our Father in heaven is with you right there at this moment and will see us through when, you know, through these times. And I, as, you know, following this soul, you know, method of studying scriptures, as for scripture, O for observation, A for application, and P for prayer. I always like to say, you know, that we should reinforce the scripture with the scripture and to interpret the scripture with the scripture. And I would like to encourage you to read Romans 8, chapter 8, because it's a chapter that it's so powerful, because it really reinforces to us who we are in Christ, what we have in Him. And that, and I just like to read for you a portion of this chapter that says, you know, who can separate us from the love of Christ? Shall be trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or danger or sword? No, no. In all these things, we're more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. So, I just would like to finish with a suggestion. Last week, I, you know, Lynn shared with me a video of all these Brazilians singing together from their balconies during this quarantine time. And they were singing Because He Lives. And it is such a powerful message in this hymn, you know. So just, you know, just bring this truth, these kind of messages to be cultivating in your heart daily, you know, moment by moment. Really for evil not to conquer you, but for you to conquer evil by the power of God, by the power of the Holy Spirit that is already in you. Amen. So I just would like to finish, you know, reading these few verses of this hymn that says, God sent His Son, they called Him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know He holds the future, and life is worth the living just because He lives. Amen. God bless you.